Welcome to In the Search. I'm your host, Scott Sanders, and this is your one-stop shop for all your speedy reviews and your detailed how-tos. Today is a speedy review through the MGM Grand Hotel and Casino in beautiful Las Vegas. Yeah, but is there a difference? Like, really? Is there a difference? But today we're going to do a speedy review. We're going to shoot through here. Now, back in this casino, it splits and goes off to the right and left. Right side's more of like entertainment stuff. Left side's all casino and gambling. But since it splits, I'm going to start on the right side by the pools. You've seen the pools. And we'll start from there and work our way back. All right? Hope you enjoy this video because I know your time's valuable and so is mine. So let's get straight to it. So at the front are the entries of the drop-off. You have the luggage rack storage area. They will hold your luggage all day. So if you show up early at 12, they can hold on to your luggage while you go in the casino and play. Or if you're leaving late on the flight, they can do the same. Just hold on to it. You have the check-in. You can pay online on the app to do an early check-in or a late check-out, which is a nice option. And then you have your concierge service. And yes, that was Leo the Lion. And we got his butt. All right, let's go to that little split in the road, and we'll start on the right side of the building. Okay, this is the 11th floor, room 425. So this is what you get. Definitely check online for their rates and rooms because you get so many different rooms. This is a Staywell, room 425 on the 11th floor. It's a Staywell room. It was originally about $250, $275, but they changed the rates to about $104. It's paparazzi weekend, first week of August, 2022. All right, so you do get the ice bucket, you do get your cups, you get a storage, you also get the drawer or the dresser that has a ghost in it and keeps opening itself. You get a TV. Now, they do have a mini bar. First little trick, this thing has a lock on it, and you want to keep it that way. You try to take stuff out of this and reload it back up, it is $50 to restock everything back in there. Everything in there is about $20. It also comes with your own water and beef jerky. But everything on here is a $50 restocking fee. And the water is about $20 each. So anything in there after they hold it completely stocked, it's about $300 to $400. You don't want to touch that. You want to get your own. Hopefully you get a little cooler. Just fill it up with ice. Or I turn the sink into a cooler sometimes because it's unlimited ice. You get a trash can. You get a light. Has plugs in. You get a desk. All the luggage in the corner is my wife's and mine. So you don't get that. You do get a view of some of the hotels, Mandalay Bay and such. Lighting, two queens, a dresser. They do get a phone. Every day they will charge you a $39 resort fee, which is Wi-Fi, telephone, the usage of the pools. So you have to can't get out of that one, but they're also now, this is your closet. So it does have a few hangers. Say it's about 12. Luggage rack, an ironing board, and an iron. Last time we didn't have one. That's a nice upgrade. Then your bathroom. Didn't come with blow dryer and stuff on the bottom right. That's my wife. We just stocked with towels, soap. Hello there, beautiful. That's my wife's stuff, but you do get a tissue. Toilet. Some nice art. I would say it's pretty modern. It's pretty nice. Tub shower combo. Handrails. Now also with this room, they have a liability fee now that's $100 a night, about $100, $103 a night. And that's for if you break the TV, break a lamp, some other stuff, they charge you for that. So for our stay for four nights, it was $400, something else to add into your total bill. But this is the room you get in a Staywell at the MGM Grand Las Vegas. Furthermore, they also have no smoking. It will be a $500 charge to your room, and that includes cigarettes, e-cigarettes, vapors, and marijuana. So yeah, so I think Las Vegas is a weed city now, but don't do it in your room. So this is what your hallways look like. They have wallpaper floral on the left side, but normally when you're coming from the elevator, that's the way you come from, and you end up going that way. So in general, the wallpaper will be on your right, the flowers on the floor will be on your right, so you know if you're coming or going down a hallway. As long as you have the flat on the right, you're going towards the elevators. You have the floor on your right, you're headed down to the end of the hall. Then at the end, they do have a soda machine, which is where the ice machine normally is. So at the end of the hall, they will have an ice machine around one of these corners. It's unlimited, so that way you can turn your sink or ice chest into a cooler. You can go to CVS or Walgreens and get a cooler and then fill it up here because you don't want that huge charge of the minibar. And then there's your elevators. You cannot get on the elevators without your room key. Your room key only lets you go to your certain floor. You can go down any way you want, but getting up to your room has to be your room and your floor. When you're doing your wings, it's elevator, 100 wing, 200 wing, 300 has the ice machine, then you got the 400 wing. So this is the 300 wing, and bam, here's your unlimited ice machine. Okay, this is the fountain area. This is where all the elevators are at. That goes to one wing. This goes to floors 4 through 12. So these are the four pools of the MGM Grand. I do have a video on them separately and everything that comes with them. They do have alcohol down there, private cabanas. They do have a lazy river. They do have lockers, so if you need to buy that for them. You can check out my other video on the MGM Grand pool. This is included with your resort fee for $39 a day. Free for you, but MGM Grand owns most of the hotels on the Strip, about half of them, and you cannot go to different ones like Bellagio and other ones and use their pools without paying a resort fee. Okay, so this is the east side of the building. That's the pool. You just saw the lovely pools. And down to the right, where you go to convention areas and stuff, a whole bunch of ballrooms, the marquee ballroom, etc. So when you come here for conventions or something, that's where they go. So we're going to do the points. So this is the right side of the whole building because it splits in the middle where Leo, the lion's at. You don't need to see the outside of the building, but this will go from here, and then I'll just jump to where you can see at the very end, right where they do the shows and all that. So that way you don't have to see me walking through the whole hotel just like this, because that'll waste 20 minutes of you following along. So here they do have the MTV part and the Showtime. Let's jump down there to Hunger Games. That's where we just came from in the pool area. You see the Hunger Game experience. They do have the monorail behind this building. This is their restaurant inside, Nelly's Southern Chicken. This is the Grand Garden Arena, which you go off to the right. They do Jabberwockies, David Copperfield. And the best thing, cool story, is when I was a kid coming here, I did a David Copperfield show, and they threw beach balls in the crowd. And if you caught one, they let you go up on stage. The act was called 13, so there's 13 of us, and they gave me and another girl a flashlight, put us in two rows of chairs, and they made us disappear in front of the whole crowd. Spoiler, I'm not going to tell you how that went because it is a great story, and you need to see the show because magic is awesome, but once you know the tricks, it all fades away. So, moving on, this is the food court. I have another separate video of the MGM Grand food court. And you can see Jabberwocky's plan, and you can see your retail. So we were just there, and you also have the smoke shop, another restaurant. Another thing, if you're in this hotel, if you get credits for booking it, they say that you can use $100 credits there for all bars and restaurants, not gift shops or retail. So if they say $100 credit, you can use it towards food and other places. All right, other side of the food court, you got Brad Garrett's Comedy Club. Another bar, piano, more retail. And then you do have Emeril Lagasse's restaurant. Haven't tried it yet, but will on this day. And it is the first week of August 2022. Tom Colicchio's Craft Steak. I did do that one. I do have a separate video for this one. I'm from Texas, so we have a lot of good steakhouses. So it's kind of hard to want to pay $80 to $120 for a steak. But nonetheless, it is good. He's the guy from Chopped. Or not Chopped. Top Chef, and then Morimoto's. He's from Iron Chef. So let's go down there and see the casino. Okay, from Morimoto's, then you go to the Most Wanted Bar. So you have to forgive me for my voice being a little raspy, because last night we were in here doing karaoke, and I did Sir Mix-a-Lot's Baby Got Back, and we tore the place to pieces. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, but right now I'm breaking the rules, because now you get to know. Let's go to the end of that row. So from that corner, we come down. You have the ticket office where you can get David Copperfield. Terry Fader won the best show in Vegas. He's pretty darn good. Everybody knows why. You have the Jabberwockies. You have Cirque du Soleil. And they have something special, probably a car giveaway. Automatic roulette. I like the normal roulette tables. Those are the elevators that go up to your room. Let's go to that end. Yeah, in between you have the Wolfgang Puck restaurant. They have a salmon pizza. I'm not even a salmon like lover, but that pizza is pretty darn good. And again, slot machines, the worst bet in Vegas, but everybody plays them because they want their money to stretch. All right, go on to the wall. Right, we came from over there, and this is where it splits, the fork in the road. That's the front lobby, which I started my video at, and it splits, so that's why I went to one side of the building to show you the way back. There's Whiskey Lounge. That place is pretty pricey. Got about 3 mimosas and 2 shots. It's like 85 bucks. So let's go to this corner. That was the main entrance and the split in the road. So, like I said, center of the casino on the left side is way more gaming. This is all your blackjack. This is all your roulette. And they do have it for $15 minimum during the day, $25 at nighttime. And some people just don't know that you're doing a video. Also, on a further note, get an M Life card. If you come here, get a card. Some people have rumors like, oh, well, the M Life card is tracking you. It shows how much you bet. It has all your information. No. All they care about is how much you bet per hand and how long you stay there. That gives them some multiples to where they can figure out how much they could probably get from you so they can do comps. The only way you're gonna get comps is if you're betting like at a roulette table and you're doing 15 bucks a hand. I was there for 6 hours. They gave me a free room for 4 nights to stay next time. My wife does paparazzi, so we're here on the convention. I came back over here for free. I was checking the prices. I should have paid between $900 to $1,200, but it was free because I gambled. So if you lose money and it's on that card, they normally try to give it back to you somehow. With free stays, shows, you name it. They're called comps, but that's what you want to go for. So get you an M Life card, because when you're in those restaurants and all the entertainment I've shown you and bars, you can use those receipts, or you can hand your card to the people in the restaurant, and if they can look at your rewards, they'll give you the points. If they can't, you take them back to this desk over here that I'll be showing you next, because they can add it all up and those points do count. That way you come to Vegas for free. You can also get free drinks, free shows, free food. That's where we were just at. And again, more roulette tables, more blackjack. It's slower this week, so I don't think they were going to be crazy this thing, but that's where you get your MGM rewards. That's the cashier, so you can cash in for chips or you can cash out for cash. They also have the casino bar off to the right. Sorry if I'm moving fast. This casino is huge. It's like walking through a mall. So we were from over there. There's the David Copperfield Theater. Sweet show. And there's your MGM reward. So definitely get that. Get you an M Life card. That's where you're going to get your comps. There's the cashier. More tables, more gaming. And back there on the right is where they'll have their videos on for gaming. That way you can do sports bets. Also, it doesn't just work at the MGM Grand. The MGM Grand owns half of the places on the Strip. Bellagio, etc., etc. You can just look at the app or get online. You can see which ones they own. You can stay in all those rooms for free for a week. So definitely get that M Life card. Make sure you hand it to somebody when you play roulette or blackjack. Just hand it to them. Those will slide your name through it. They'll check you out. And every now and then, what your highest bet is, you'll hear them call it out, and that's because they want to keep track of it to just know how much you're betting. Again, it's not how much you win or lose. They don't care. They just want to know what your standard bet and how long you're playing there. Okay, we just came from there. And again, more slots. Everybody loves that. I am going to make a roulette video and a blackjack video and a Texas Hold'em one, so y'all can stay tuned. I'll give y'all the best ways to have the best edge in the casino. Coming from there, and we go to the MGM Grand Buffet. It's about 35 bucks a person, all you can eat, but most places you eat here are about 30 bucks a plate, so why not get all you can eat? This is the TV and online gambling area, so you can go on horse races, baseball games, football games, you name it, that's where it's at. And you got the backside of the casino that goes to the Vegas Strip, which is the west side or the left side. Tap, another great beer joint. Okay, from there, from the betting area, then you also have back in the corner that goes to the back alley in the street to the Strip. You do have the New York Pizzeria. You do have a gaming area that has tons of normal video games, a bar area, more arcade for the kids in the backside. It goes up to another level. All right, so the escalator does go up to the top, and it makes it a way across there and gives you a bridge to go across the street at the end of the Strip. But this is the end of the casino on the Strip side. So again, thanks for stopping by. You think I deserve it, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. If you do, you're gonna get like 50 plus videos on me. But remember, I only do this for y'all. I don't wanna be sponsored by anybody. I test and try everything. I'm not gonna do a review or a how-to unless it's really good and it's gonna help you out in the future. Again, thanks for stopping by M to Search. Y'all have a great weekend. And remember, there is no I in team, but there is a me. So next time your coach is asked that, you can make a difference. But it is always best to play as a team. Have a great weekend.